I don't know how much you've crossed paths with Ty Law, but, you know, I was talking about Ty earlier on the program. He's essentially the first of the Belichick, Kraft, and Brady era of Patriots to get into the Hall of Fame. He's basically breaking ground for something that we're going to see a lot of guys getting in. I wonder your 2 cents on that subject.
Yeah, I totally agree. Ty and I are actually very close. I was there with Ty and had the great blessing to coach him and be on those great teams with him. And unbelievable competitor, great guy. Obviously, when I was still in New England, he was, still out in the area. Just being able to connect to him after the playing years, and he very much so, wanted to know how my kids were doing and just involved with a lot of the families and stuff. He's an unbelievable person. So excited, so happy for him, so well-deserved, and certainly, one of the best that I've been around. So what a great event. But I agree. I think, Ty is breaking ground. I think there is going to be a lot of guys coming out of that era that are going to be, walking through Canton, and we'll be looking forward to all of them. It's just such a special time for those guys and the early part of the 2000s, and what a great group of guys.
Yeah, and I'm just wondering who else should get in and how sometimes we don't hear their names mentioned very often because of the do your job mantra and how much credit Coach Belichick, in many ways deservingly so, does get for these teams and their success, and there's no real individual standout because of the team mentality. Who do you think should stand out and get into the Hall of Fame from those years, Coach?
Yep, you got me right there. So I'm going to stay with the team mentality that was bred so well into us in those years. I think all of them deserve it. I mean, it was great, great teams. Certainly, Coach Belichick is where it all starts, and unbelievable, opportunity to work with him and learn from, the greatest and just be around him all the time. But there's so many good players from those teams. I hate to just ramble off some names and forget someone because, honestly, where does it stop between, the defensive crew, Teddy Bruschi, Mike Vrabel, Junior Seau, Willie McGinnis. I mean, obviously all those guys we had to pick from, which were unbelievable, play with, which is unbelievable, in the room at the time, to the offensive guys. I mean, all of them. I mean, it's just a great group of players.
Yeah, and there's also the World Series of Poker champ, in a way, Richard Seymour. I mean, you got him, too.
I mean, the whole front line. I mean, Richard and Ty Warren on the other side, and Vince, obviously, in the middle. And, look, everybody had a role on the team, and everybody executed it at a high level. Jarvis Green would come in, and, he'd get his plays. But, for us, I think it is exactly what you said. It was all about team, and those guys, that's what they believed in, and that's what they played for. So it's hard to separate anybody out.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.